Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today I will show you how we can create a scene in the Unreal Engine by transferring the mesh we modeled in Blender. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will add a circle for our scene and we will set up our vertices 7. And after that, as the same modeling pattern, in the tab to edit mode, E to extrude, right click and S to scale, you can model your temple with this method. And we will model a column. You can check my other videos on the YouTube. We made this type of models in our scene. I am making this part speedily. And I will show you how can we transfer our high poly details to the low poly details for our column. Before all of this, check the wireframe. And after that, you can add multi-res modifier and subdivide 5 times. As you see, this is too dense for sculpting. And go to sculpting part. We will add new texture. Set your mapping stencil. As the falloff, it will be sphere. And under the texture settings, you can open your alpha texture. I will link in description. And under the brush settings, you can set up your stroke method, anchored. As you see, it came in here. With the shift, you can scale it and place it. And after that, as the radial Z, you can set it 4. Now, with the mouse left button, drag your brush and drop. And it will give your ancient texture in the sculpting. For the other part, we will use same method. You can add extra details in the sculpting for your column. And we will transfer these details from high poly to low poly. As you see, our column will look like that. From the multi-res, decrease your level viewport 0. After that, choose some edge lines. In edit mode, you can right click and mark seam them. If it's too hard for you, if you want, you can use some Smart UV Projected too. In the UV Edit tab, select All with A and U Unwrap. For the separate your some parts of your UV maps, you can add extra detail mark seam in edges. And again, right-click mark seam, U and Unwrap. I am getting my UV map like this. And now go to Shading tab. We will add a new material for this. And Shift-A, add image texture. Press New and set up your normal texture in here. Set your width and height as a 4K and press OK. Color space will be non-color. When it's selected, from the left texture part, you can choose your new texture we created. Under the render engine, don't forget to choose cycles. Under the bake, check your bake from multi-res. And after pressing bake, it will give you normal map like this. And it looks good for now. And don't forget to save as your column normal map. Now we will add normal map node with Shift A and connect the color to color and normal maps normal to principal VSDF normal nodes. And it will look like that. For seeing this clearly, you can change its color too. As you see, this is low poly. And now we will get some displacement bake. You can add new image texture in here too and press new button. Set up your displacement column. Set your quality 4K and check bit float. Under the bake type, you can change it displacement and press bake again. It will give a displacement map for us and we can save as it. For the connecting displacement, with the Shift A, you can add displacement mode, connect your color to height and material output displacement. It will affect. It can't see in clearly in here, but in the Unreal Engine, you will get some difference. Again, we will add some image texture in here and connect color to base color. You can open a texture as a base color. I downloaded something from the 3D textures me. You can find some marble materials from them. For to make it lighter, you can add extra bright contrast node between them. And for the roughness, I will add image texture again and connect roughness to color. You can choose your roughness map. As you see, this is too shiny. For decrease it, you can add some color ramp and play with your nodes in here. When you drag your white node, it will be getting rough. With the pressing Ctrl T, you can add your mapping nodes and connect them to the vectors. You can add new image texture in here because we will get some big process for our roughness and diffuse map. Set up your new image as a 4K. Uncheck your bake from multi-res and choose diffuse. And uncheck your direct and indirect. And bake your textures. It can has most of method with the add-ons. Maybe it can be easy too. But I am making simplistic things because I want to show you how to make some scene in Unreal basic method. For the temple, ground and roof parts, you can add some marble materials. I'm making bake process for this, but this is not good bake process because with the unwrapping, my UV maps have too much space. So if you want to bake clearly or you want to real game assets for yourself to working on the Unreal Engine, watch some professional 3D artists video. You can learn real professional bake process from them. I will learn them too. As you see, our temple will look like that. Under the Unreal Engine, we will choose third person when your starter screen. Choose your folder and after that give a project name. Don't forget to check the starter content. As you see, it will open it like that. Under the file, press new level and choose empty. Under the environment light mixer, choose all of the height, fog and sky atmosphere. Under the selection mode, set up your landscape from the left menu and press create. As you see, our scene landscape will look like that. Go to edit, plugins and type water. Choose these two plugins and restart your Unreal Engine. After you restart it, under the all classes, you can type in here water and choose water body lake. Drag and drop to your scene. After compile, it will be came in here like that. As you see, our water is look like really clear. With the little side vertices, control vertices, you can set up your scale, rotate and making place like that for your lake. And after that, choose your water body lake from the right. Under the rendering, double click your water material. As you see, there are some parameters in here. You can set up your water waves, caustics and randomize of your waves. And with the fluid simulation and displacement, you can set up your own things on your water. If you make ocean, you can change it. If you make lake or river, you can change it. And now you can set up your color from here. If you want, you can make it red or yellow, how you want. From the Quicksilver Bridge, as you see, we will download something from here for our scene because we only modeled a temple in the Blender and I will make a different scene in here, but I want to use some Quicksilver Bridge assets for my scene. You can download after you can press add. When you edit, it will came under the Megascans folder 3D assets. As you see, Nordic Forest Cliff is came in here. You can scale it and place where you want in your scene in the Unreal Engine. With the holding Alt, you can duplicate your cliff and you can rotate it. and I will download something different. I downloaded some ground material from here for my landscape. Under the landscape material, from the content folder, you can drag and drop onto landscape material. It will affect it like that. Under the tiling, offset and rotation angle, you can set up them. Off the water and adding some extra rocks behind from the Quicksilver Ridge again. Now I will download some grass for my scene and I will edit my project. For the using this, we will change our mode to the foliage. Under the foliage, as you see, you can shift and select all your grasses from here. From the top, you can set up your brush size, paint density. If you want to erase it, you can set it up from your foliage settings. And I am painting my scene with the grasses. We will choose all of our temple, export and FBX. Under of it, as a pad mode, click copy and check this. Choose selected objects, object types mesh, under the geometry, choose face. And after that, export your FBX. In the Unreal Engine, you can create a new folder with the right click. And we will choose our FBX in here, drag and drop our content part. And press import all. Choose your temple parts with the shift and drag and drop to your scene. Now you can scale it. Some textures can be look bad or some texture may be missing. You can drag and drop your baked textures to here too. For example, for the column, I couldn't find any normal and base color maps. And I am adding later them. After the materials, you can double click on it from the right menu. You can delete them. Choose your textures, baked textures. Drag and drop your material view, separate them, and connect them each other. As you see, our material came in here. Choose all of your temple parts and create new folder under of it. We can choose them easily. As you see, I downloaded some trees for my scene. In Quicksilver Ridge Asset, I couldn't find them, so I downloaded them from the Unreal Engine Marketplace from the Epic Games. You can type megasequence tree. These are tree folders. You can download them and add to your project. As you see, under the Common Hazel and Geometry Pivot Painter, you can drag and drop them and scale to add your scene. For the foliage, you can use other grass method for the foliage. And under the starter content pack and particle, you can add some fire particles for your temple. After you can move and rotate them, you can give some effect for your cups. As you see, I set up my scene light. With the pressing Ctrl L and continue to keep holding and move your mouse, you can set up your daylights as a sunset or sunrise, maybe noon. You can set it up your skylight like that. I am making a bit the evening type of the light. Under the exponential height fog, you can choose this. And under the right menu, fog density, you can set it up how you want. Under the sky atmosphere ambient color, you can change it, maybe purple, maybe green, how you want, you can set it up. With the directional light, you can set up your intensity from here. And now, we will add some under the cinematic and cinema camera actor. As you see, we have a camera in our scene. From the little screen, you can see where our camera look. You can rotate it and place it. Right click, edit and rename your camera name. And after that, from the perspective, choose your main temple camera for this. Now, you can control your camera with W, A, S, D. Now, under this, you can add level sequence. Create yourself new sequence. And after that, you can set up your last keyframe here. And move your camera, drag and drop, left part of the sequencer. Under the transform, press and add new key for your camera. And move your camera how you want to give your effect. And after that, press transform again, set up your other key. With the pressing space, you can see how does your cinematic look like. Under the edit plugins type movie render, and don't forget to check your movie render queue and other option. You can restart maybe under the window, set up your cinematic movie render queue. After you select it, press plus render and choose your main temple sequence and press unsaved part. Under the JPEG, I will delete this and I will add my PNG sequence. Now, you can set up your output folder, output resolution from here. Use the custom frame rate maybe if you want. And don't forget to add your anti-aliasing. And you can set up your temporal sample count 64 or 32. After all of that, press render local. And after the compile, it will give you a render preview like that. When it's finished, you can get all your PNGs from here. I'm making simplistic way in the Unreal Engine to creating my scene. I will make another tutorials about it with the detail. And don't forget to like and subscribe. I will make new Unreal Engine and Blender tutorials with detailed explanation. In this video, I wanted to show how can we use this easily, but if it's too confusing for you, I will make new videos about the Unreal Engine and Blender. Don't forget to check my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. See you later.